generalizing information. And this means that if you teach me something in the comfort of my house, I can easily go outside and apply that same behavior that I learned, and it's no problem. But in the dog's world, they don't seem to translate that as well. So, and it can be as easy as I might teach Loki in this far corner of the room how to do a trick, and then when I simply transplant him to a different part of the room, or a different part of my house, or anything, he might have a little bit lost in translation. He might not do that trick as well. So this game kind of helps with that. So what we're going to do is start asking him in more creative ways, just by moving our own body or moving his placement around me and adding a level of distraction that he's not used to. So I am armed with a handful of treats, and I have my clicker on, and we want to use the clicker because this helps mark the exact behavior. That's important at this point in time because we're not asking him for any duration on the sit, so it might be a very momentary thing, especially if it's in a new environment. So I am going to click this box as soon as his butt hits the floor, so he knows that's the exact act that I want. And that's kind of like a promise that he's going to get a treat. Now, if you are at home watching this video and you don't have a clicker on you, you can simply use a word like yes. So right when your dog's butt hits the floor, you would say yes, and that's a promise that they're going to get the treat. That's important, so you don't hand them the treat while they're standing or jumping on you if you're not using what we call those secondary reinforcers. So what I'm going to do with Loki is he understands sit with a verbal and a hand signal. So we're going to ask him both ways each time to make it easy on him. And I taught him sitting in a chair, so that's the way we're going to start. So assistant Loki, can you come here for a second? And we're just going to ask him the way he knows, sit. Good job, click and treat that. And then the next time, I'm going to stand up, because that's a normal place that I might ask him. So I'm going to say, sit. Good job. Fantastic. And from this point on, I can get as creative as I want with movement or placement around me. So for instance, Loki, how about this time we do it in walking position? So I'm going to say, sit. Good job. Fantastic. And then this time, maybe you go to your mark. So we'll just add up points for this. Sit. So let's say that's 4 points. Yay, Loki, 4 points. You did it. High five. Okay. Now, next time, I might get a little creative. So this time, I think I'll stand on the mark. So I'm a little bit higher. Sit. Oh, we got an itch. Come here, buddy. Loki's got some allergies kicking. Good sit. All right, and then I might crouch down, sit, because he's a short little dog. And then I might even lay down on the floor. Oh, sit. Yes, good sit. Very good boy. And then I can also add some motion. So I might walk back and forth. Loki, sit. Yay, good job. And then I might, oh, I don't know, wave my hands. Loki, sit. Yay! Good job! And then we'll go high. Can you sit? Oh, that's a jump. That's the hard one. Sit. Yay! Good job! We got it. Get that crown. Okay, so let's say that was, I don't know, 7 or 8 different ways that we did our sit challenge today. So that would be a great number to start with. Now, from this point on, every day, I'm going to add different variations and make it as fun as I can. So I'm asking my dog to do it in just strange different positions. So I might stand on something, I might stand on one leg, and make it creative and make it fun to do that basic command in a repetitive nature like that. So this week, it's your job to try and do the sit challenge with your dog. Once you do it a few days, even a week, your dog has gotten so much stronger with that command and you're ready to take it out in the real world. So the challenge is up to you guys. How many ways can you get your dog to sit this week? Good job, Loki. Good job.